Food can be a major source of conflict in people's lives. Susan's battle with food took her down a dangerous path of drug addiction she thought she would never escape.
I think I had a food problem long before I knew I had a food problem. I was into food as a kid. I could make you Thanksgiving dinner at the age of 8. I'm not even kidding. Food became my companion, my excitement. That's when I was like, I am a food addict. It was a nightmare the way my weight just progressively kept climbing and climbing. When I was 14, I tried my first drug. It was psychedelic mushrooms. It was amazing. I felt free. I felt alive. And I woke up the next day and I stepped on the scale and I'd lost 7 pounds in that one night. I was blown away. And I remember committing to myself that I was gonna do that every chance I got, that I'd found the answer, finally. And I did. I was doing drugs to stay thin. And then when I was 16, I found crystal meth and it really accelerated from there. I would do crystal meth so intensely, no sleeping, no food, no water for 4, 5, 6, 7 nights at a time, just continuously awake. I lost 30 pounds in a couple months. I started having delusions, hallucinations, drug-induced psychosis, and I had to drop out of high school. I started doing cocaine, and that morphed into doing crack cocaine. During that time, I lost everything. I became a call girl. I started sleeping on the streets. It was a dark, scary place. And it all came to a head on August 9th of 1994. I just turned 20 years old. And I was in a crack house. I'd been smoking for 3-4 days continuously. And I just had this awareness. And I knew right then that if I didn't get up and get out of there right then, that that's all I was ever gonna be. I ended up going to a 12-step program, and I haven't had a drink or a drug in 22 and a half years. So I stopped using the drugs, and that was great, but I got fat really fast, 40, 50 pounds, almost immediately. Essentially, I replaced my drug addiction with my food addiction. Like, I could eat most of a pizza, and then a big pot of pasta, and then a pint of ice cream, and then cupcakes, pies, cakes. My binges were so vicious. At one point, I gained 16 pounds in 1 week. One time, my stomach lining ruptured, and I wasn't able to stand up. And I knew that if I didn't really tackle my food addiction like I'd tackled my drug addiction, I was never gonna live the life that I was meant to live.
She's tackled both, and a lot has changed since Susan was battling her food and drug addiction. Today, she's clean, healthy, and a neuroscientist. And Susan, I have to commend you for turning your life around. How did you go from being a drug meth addict to getting your PhD?
I pass for normal now. It's great. I had to start small. I enrolled in community college, and I did well there, and I transferred to UC Berkeley. And then I went on to get my PhD in brain and cognitive sciences, and then did a 2-year postdoctoral fellowship in psychology at the University of New South
Wales. A lot of this driven by your past experiences?
Yeah, I wanted to know how it is that a brain like mine can go so far off the rails.
And so where in the mix did overcoming the food addiction come? How were you able to do that?
Well, that took a lot longer. For me, food was harder than drugs, by far.
And anyone watching, think about that. It was harder for Susan to overcome her food addiction than her drug addiction.
Yeah. For me, it was learning what the addictive foods are. It's sugar and flour, and becoming willing to abstain from them completely, like I abstained from drugs completely.
And you actually wrote a book, right? Called Bright Line Eating. So tell us about your method.
Yeah, so bright lines are clear, unambiguous boundaries that you just don't cross. I need a bright line for sugar and flour. I don't eat them ever, and that's how I've been able to maintain, you know, a slender weight now for over 14 years.
And what I love the most about you is now that you understand how the addictive brain works, both professionally and personally, you're now using that to influence others.